Ladies and gentlemen, in this video recipe, Nonna is going to show you how to make the most delicious, the perfect chicken broth. And she's going to serve it with beautiful, moist crepes. Oh yeah, this is Nonna's recipe, Nonna traditional recipe. Stay tuned. Hi and welcome to
Vincenzo's Plate.
Yay, with Nonna's Plate.
Nonna's Plate.
And Giulia, cousin Giulia. Today we're making chicken broth.
Broth all'abruzzese.
Abruzzo style. Giulia, che cos'è questo? Is this the best broth?
È una specialità del nostro territorio, poi come la fa la nonna, mwah.
It is a specialty from Abruzzo. And the way nonna does it, Giulia said, is mwah.
Vedi così, mwah.
You know what this means? Delicious.
Racchiude tutto.
And nonna is going to serve this chicken broth with crepes. So it's a traditional dish made in the province of Teramo, where nonna is from, called scrippellenbus.
Allora, prendiamo il pollo, lo mettiamo...
You get a nice piece of chicken.
Ecco.
What kind of it is? Mm. And guys, you need to know that this chicken is super organic.
And
come from nonna's sister.
Insieme alla carne ci mettiamo qualche pezzetto di vitello che lo rende ancora più buono.
So chicken, half chicken, but you also need to use a little pieces of veal. The veal helps to
adesso,
make the chicken broth taste better.
Adesso mettiamo l'acqua.
Now we fill up this pot with water.
Scalinato.
Okay, so
ecco.
This is how much water you can.
Questo che adesso si prende e si mette sul fornello.
Put on the stove.
Sui fornelli. Si copre.
Make sure you cover it with a lid.
Quando bolle poi si guarda.
When it boils, you need to keep an eye on it. Nonna is teaching Giulia how to peel the carrots and how to clean the onion. This is family. This is what food can do. Food brings people together. Giulia?
Yeah.
Nice.
Il brodo è arrivato che si deve fare questo servizio.
So when the broth does this, you need to remove the foam created on top. You don't want to see that. You remove this, but this only happens once the water starts to boil. See, come and have a look. See, the oil now comes out. And that's what you want. You want the oil. Mm. Yummy. So once you remove all of that, all this foam, you put the flavors. So
cipolla,
one onion, three stalks of celery,
carota,
one carrot that is peeled,
cannella.
Here we have cinnamon. If you don't have cinnamon, the stick, you can't use powder. You have to go and buy the stick, the cinnamon stick. Nonna also add two little pomodori.
Ci mette due, tre pomodorini per le piccole
pacchini. Little cherry tomatoes she puts in there. Give more flavors.
So the broth, or basically the chicken, cooks depending on how tender it is. So it can take even just an hour to make a beautiful broth, but nonna usually lets it boil for at least 2 hours. So the water is nicely infused, not only with all the flavors, but also with the chicken, and it gets nice and tender.
Grazie nonna, il tuo brodo è meraviglioso.
Sente, già si sente l'odore.
You can already smell the beautiful flavors.
Ecco, poi ci si mette pure i pomodorini, questi pacchini.
Nonna likes to put cherry tomatoes in the broth as well.
So you put them in whole with the skin?
Oh yeah.
Anche con...
Con la pelle e tutto.
Sì, così. Perché dopo si deve colare.
Ecco, so you know, it gives a flavor. And
dopo si cola.
When you get the broth, you're gonna put it through the colander. So you're not gonna eat it the way it is. Nonna said you have to add some sea salt in there, nice amount of sea salt.
Ecco.
Because it gives more flavor. Prego, nonna.
Mettiamo il sale grosso, così. Poi si assaggia se è buono, se ci vuole.
And you try it. And if it's good, that's it. You don't need to add any more salt.
Non un paio di ore, secondo come è la carne. Se la carne è tenera, di meno, pure con un'ora. Okay. Però se la carne si deve guardare quando è cucinata.
Boil it now from now for two hours. But this depends on the meat. She's using organic meat and it's an old chicken. If you use a not organic chicken, probably in one
si
hour.
Deve guardare quando
you need
è
to
cotto.
Keep an eye and feel the chicken. Nonna said to make sure when is it ready? Mm. It's ready when you put the fork inside the chicken and the whole fork goes inside. Mm. It should be super moist and it's still tough. Mm. So it probably needs another hour, nonna. Mm. One more hour. The broth is cooking. Now we need to make the crepes. So nonna's recipe is each egg you can make three crepes with one egg. So nonna is using about 8 eggs, so she wants to make 24 crepes, I guess, for the family. Quante ne mangi tu oggi di crepe, nonna?
Non vediamo, perché... Ecco, così.
Look at nonna, look what she did. Notice this. The reason why she opened the last egg from the top is because she's using this egg as a measurement for the next ingredients. So, wash it first.
Mettiamo un po' di sale.
Put a little bit of salt, about one...
Così.
2 teaspoons.
Adesso con questo battiamo bene bene.
Mix very well. Nonna, I'm a home cook and I don't have an electric mixer. I like to do it by hand.
8 uova. Adesso metto 8 cucchiai di farina.
Nonna used 8 eggs, so she's putting 8 spoons of flour. So each egg you get 1 spoon of flour.
Metti qua.
Hi. And she's adding the flour a little bit at a time.
E 2 ne ho messo.
3 4 5 6 7 8. You have to mix it very well, otherwise you get lumps. You don't want lumps. You have to mix it very well so the flour disappear. And then we're gonna add a little bit of water to make it nice and runny. So the reason why Nonna kept the egg and broke it from the top is because she's going to fill them up with water. So there is water inside. So 8 eggs, 8 spoons of flour, 8 eggs full of water. So metto nonna.
Sì.
1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 Nice mix. That's how simple it is to make crepes.
Adesso questa si riposa un pochino, si dense un pochino in più.
Non ha said let it rest a little bit so it becomes more dense.
Si mette un pochino, facciamo vedere, mettere nel frigorifero un pochino, poi
she likes to put in the fridge for a couple of minutes. Look what's happening over here, okay? Nonna is putting extra virgin olive oil.
Su la teglia.
On the pan.
Now, riscaldare.
You wait until it warms up. You need the pans to be nice and hot. If they are not hot, the crepes don't turn out, okay? So,
prendiamo.
Look at this, what he's doing. You get...
Prendo.
The crepes, and that's what you do. You have to be very fast with your wrist. Look how nonna, look how fast she is with her wrist.
Ecco.
You just do that, and that takes no time to do it. And again, look.
A 2.
You put the eggs on top and look, the movement of your wrist.
Ecco.
It takes no time to make the crepe. The first one never turns out. La prima di solito si rompe sempre, nonna.
No, non si rompe niente.
No, non si è rotta. Nonna said, no, not for me.
Not this one.
You get a fork to help you, so the little fork can help you to turn them around. Nice. Ready in less than 30 seconds, your crepe is ready.
Okay. Togliete, che è pronto. Susi.
Giulia, mine is better. Look, Giulia.
No,
look,
no.
Look, I think mine is better. We ask our friends who
made the best one.
Look,
l'hai girato, non l'hai girato.
Nonna, chi l'ha fatta la crepe migliore? Giulio o io? Di.
Tutte e due, dai.
La nonna è imparziale.
Dai, dai, è pronto questo. Non è. Ho assaggiato uno, è buonissimo pure di sale.
Nonna tried one and it's got the perfect amount of salt. Bello.
Questo è più bello, così.
Just put the nicer ones on top.
Guarda quanto sono belle, mi avanta da solo.
Nonna said, look how beautiful they are.
Prollo, il brodo è pronto.
The broth is nice and ready. Oh, look at that. Look at the beautiful color.
Le crepe sono pronte, si sono raffreddate.
The crepes are ready, they are cold.
Prendiamo il parmigiano.
Get the parmesan. And put the parmesan on top. This is crippellenbus.
Ci mettiamo il parmigiano, poi si prende così, si rotola.
You roll them up like spring rolls. You put parmesan in the crepes, roll them up.
Uno si mette qua.
So, you get a nice amount of parmigiano.
Uno metto tutto quello che gli piace, come gli piace.
You put as much as you like. Then you roll them up. And again, you put them in there. And what we do, we put them in a bowl, one on top of each other, because after we put the broth in there. So they will be soaked in the broth. And it's such a beautiful culinary experience. An amazing experience, thanks to the tradition, thanks to Nonna.
Si chiama così perché c'è il broth, si chiama Skrippellenbus.
So Skrippelle in dialect is this, Skrippelle are crepes. These are savory crepes called Skrippelle. Mbus means wet, bagnate, wet.
Bagnato col brodo.
So Skrippellenbus means
bagnato
wet
col brodo.
Crepes in dialect.
Dici che con questo ci si può fare cannelloni, lo stesso metti qua.
Nonna said you can make cannelloni with the crepes, you can
timballo.
Do lasagna.
Timballo.
Anything you like. Nice amount of parmigiano. Ho messo tanto, l'ho messo, no? Wow, ho messo tanto.
Troppo ne hai messo.
Of course. Non si da put too much parmesan.
Che dopo si va a mettere pure qua sopra un pochino.
Nice.
Ecco.
Un applauso!
Si insaporisce.
Parmesan inside, you put more
insaporisce
on top.
Il brodo.
You put
così.
More parmesan on top of the crepes. So you give more flavor to your broth. The moment of the truth. Let's see. Vai, apri. Nice and steamy. A beautiful broth. Vai, nonna.
Adesso si prende il maestro, si bella passa così.
So now we wet the crepes so we can eat them. And look how you go. Oh, look what happened there. As you get the sauce, the broth, you have the tomato over there, the onion. It is a winter dish, but we like it to eat all over the all year round. So nice, so beautiful. Brava nonna. Facciamo mangiare la nostra famiglia, dai, let's go and serve it. Andiamo a mangiare, let's go and eat. Ok, it's time to serve.
Metti il cucchiaio di là.
For nonna.
Ok, girato
ecco
così.
Qua. Tu Giulia, how many do you want?
Metti un po' di brodo.
8.
It's your turn. Ok, it's one. I'm gonna have 10 crepes. 2. Castagne di this. Ah, ok, nonna can't wait, she wants to eat. So, thank you so much for watching this episode. We will see you on the next Vincenzo's Plate video recipe. E ora?
Si mangia.
Vincenzo's Plate. Yay, a nonna's plate.
Buon appetito.
Grazie.
Buon appetito.